So if we talk about Darwinism, what is Darwinism? It is a theory that explains the evolution of new species through natural selection, and it is named after Charles Darwin. Now, Charles Darwin was a naturalist, right? What do you understand by the term naturalist? Yes, he was somebody who studied nature in nature. As a naturalist, he studied something in its natural habitat. As a naturalist, Darwin set sail on the HMS Beagle in the year 1831 to 1836, right? Why? To survey the South Seas, mainly South America as well as the Galapagos Islands, right? Why? To collect plants and animals. And what did he notice, or what did he observe on these Galapagos Islands? There, he was able to observe species that lived nowhere else in the world. He observed many weird animals with very interesting adaptations, such as sea-swimming iguanas, giant tortoises. And these giant tortoises that he found differed from one island to the next. On islands that had low plants, he found short-necked tortoises. And in islands that had high cacti and trees, there were long-necked tortoises on those islands. He also noticed that a type of bird species called the finch species that also lived on the islands were adapted to the food on which they were feeding on the different islands. He also noticed great variation among the animal populations there. His theory was that the finches all developed from a common ancestor, but the environment in which they were living forced them to adapt in order to survive. What did these observations lead to? They led to Darwin writing a book which he published in the year 1859. And this book he called On the Origin of Species by Means of Natural Selection. So this publication convinced many scientists that evolution did exist, right? And that it developed through natural selection. Now, Darwin waited 23 years before he actually published his theory on natural selection. Why? Because it was difficult for the different religions to actually understand and accept his ideas. Darwin's theory on natural selection is based on the following observations. 1. He looked at variation. 2. Offspring. 3. Competition. 4. Genetics. And 5. Natural selection. Let's take a look. To begin with, okay, he explained that organisms produce a large number of offspring, right? Within this offspring, there's going to be a great deal of variation or differences amongst the offspring. All of them are not going to be the same, right? Among them, some of them will have desirable characteristics, right? Meaning they will have advantageous variations or good genes or favorable characteristics, while some do not. So, when there is a change in the environmental conditions, or if there is competition, what do you think will happen? He explained that then organisms with those favorable characteristics, which make them more suited, right, or more adaptable, will survive, whilst the organisms with characteristics that make them less suitable to survive, less adaptable, will then die. This is termed natural selection, right? Then what happens? The organisms that will survive will go on to reproduce, and therefore they will pass their strong, their favorable, their desirable characteristics to their offspring. Then what will happen? The next generation will therefore have a higher proportion of individuals with these favorable characteristics. And in this way, the characteristics of a population gradually changes over a long period of time. And that is what his theory of natural selection explains. What is natural selection? It is when animals and plants develop characteristics that's going to give them a better chance of survival. And how is natural selection brought about? It is brought about by genetic characteristics, right? Genes on chromosomes, which are going to help the animal to survive. And if that animal survives, he has offspring, and then the offspring will have the good genetic characteristics of the strong ancestor, but the one with the weak characteristics will produce no offspring, and then that weak genetic characteristic is going to be lost. Example, a blind lion cub will never survive. The genetic material for blindness dies with it, since it has no offspring.
I hope you enjoyed our video. Like and subscribe.